don't see him on my format, do you?
Hey, we're not on anybody's format tonight.
Pardon the expression, but they're just making asses of themselves right now with this crowd. Look at that. I mean, seriously, disrespectful, rude. I mean, this is supposed to be intermission, not perfect addiction time.
Well, I tell you what, the perfect addiction have bum-rushed the Buckley Cup tonight right before intermission with an unscheduled appearance, and Perry Winkle has taken that microphone from Cody Springer.
I expect nothing less. And he's going to run down Litchfield now.
Wait a minute.
We got an open challenge?
The perfect addiction have hit the ring and thrown out an open challenge? Well, I'll tell you what, there's no shortage of guys hanging around. There's always somebody that rides with somebody. And oh my God, there is Mike Outlaw, the current reigning champion of Dynamo Pro Wrestling, and Mr. Nice, the handler of Jake Durden, and a guy that's gotten himself some huge singles wins on his own right here in the Proving Ground.
And these guys, you know, they're kind of thrown together here against a well-oiled tag team. I mean, how do you think they're going to fare in a match like this?
I don't know.
They weren't prepared for it.
No. These are guys that came along, were hoping that somebody didn't show up, hoping somebody got hurt.
Always bring your gear.
Check it out. And guess what? Opportunity came knocking. Apparently, Mr. Nice and Mike Outlaw looked at each other and said, "We got a chance to do something tonight."
The rule of wrestling is always bring your gear. You know, Brady, I brought a sports coat just in case a ring announcer didn't show up. I tried to be prepared. They were too. They get an opportunity here to shut them up. Let's see if it happens. I think everybody in the crowd wants it to.
This is a very... Now, they don't have the experience. It's a thrown together team. We're talking about two formidable guys here in the Proving Ground between Mike Outlaw. Now, this is only his third trip here. He had a dark match. He's done well in them. Since then, he's gone on to bigger and better things. Managed to capture the Dynamo Pro Heavyweight Championship down in St. Louis. Mr. Nice, meanwhile, he won the Golden Ticket Gauntlet. Or what? No, he didn't win it. He was next to last.
Yeah, yeah.
He almost won it. He was the first man in and the last man eliminated.
And not just the name alone. It was a gauntlet. These guys abused their bodies for that thing.
And so we're talking about a couple guys that have had a lot of success here in the Proving Ground. So, but not the kind of success that the Perfect Addiction has had as a tag team.
The Perfect Addiction. I mean, they've been getting around all over the Midwest lately, and they're doing everything they can to get noticed. But is this the way to go about it, really?
Apparently so, because they got themselves in the in one of the most prestigious nights on the indie circuit and found themselves a match. I guess if you force your hand, sometimes things will happen for you, but we don't know how this is going to turn. It may not turn out the way they wanted it to.
No, it may not. It may be a little bit troublesome for the boys in green and black over there.
And I'll tell you what, that may well be, because Randy Ray is in trouble right now, and Mr. Nice is tagging out to Mike Outlaw, and Mike Outlaw is taking charge of Randy Ray.
You know, it's good to mix a little tag team match in here, but it's just a shame because, again, Perfect Addiction weren't even supposed to be on the show. But you get an opportunity for a team that has not teamed before to pick up a victory. And, you know, if they pick up a victory there, what does that do for them, you know, going forward? Maybe they start to team more often. It's just an interesting scenario.
If they found themselves with a little chemistry and a big win, there's no telling what the future might hold. Both guys extremely capable, but they definitely don't have the experience as a team like the Perfect Addiction. But look, there's no doubt about it. They've got Randy Ray in some serious trouble here.
I don't think people realize how hard it is to just jump in there and start teaming. You know, You got all those brother teams in wrestling because they've been teaming their whole life. But, you know, these guys are just teaming on a whim here, hoping that they can get noticed. It's not so easy, and they've got a team that's well-oiled machine, like I said earlier.
And Randy Ray finds himself into the corner and gets a fresh as a daisy periwinkle.
Yeah, you just go back to your...
All he found was a deep arm drag from Mike Outlaw.
Go back to the basics there to take charge. You know, while they may not be a consistent tag team like the Perfect Addiction, you go back to what brought you to the dance here, and you just go to arm drags. You go to the basic things to keep them down.
Oh, and a nice soup bone from Winkle. And what a nice technician in the ring Perry Winkle is. I tell you what, not hugely well known on the independent circuit, but honestly ought to be more well known because Perry Winkle is one hell of a competitor in that
Oh,
ring.
Oh, I was afraid he sprained an ankle.
Oh, a nice
kick.
Move by Mike Outlaw.
He is a hell of an athlete, a guy that... You know, he goes in there and he does things that not a lot of people can do on the indies or anywhere else.
Mike Outlaw, what a rapidly improving guy. Really very new to the game and quickly has put himself in a position of main events on some shows and definitely getting around to a lot of places. This is a guy that can put himself on that independent map. And look at him dole out those soup bones to Periwinkle.
He is the definition of upside in pro wrestling.
Oh, but that double team maneuver, there's the tag
there
team experience.
If you take Mario Cravello and put him in a tag team, you've got the Perfect Addiction. And
Mario runs with the Perfect Addiction on a fairly regular basis, but tonight with his hands full of Buckley Cup, I don't see him out here, but that explains exactly why these two cats are in the house.
Kind of surprised that they weren't here in Mario's corner earlier, but I will tell you this. I think they're doing this for the shock value. I think that's completely within their character.
Yeah, I'm sure they enjoyed the what the hell is the Perfect Addiction here doing here moment. There's
yeah,
no
they
doubt
like
about
seeing
that.
The crowd say what the hell. I mean, they enjoyed it. You could tell they were rubbing it in, and now, you know, the fans have to sit through their obnoxiousness, but they are in control right now.
It is paying off for them. They've had a lot of success in the Proving Ground. They have really put themselves on the map on independent tag team wrestling. The Perfect Addiction is no joke. They're missing Lucy Mendez tonight. I don't know where Lucy is. I heard she was a little under the weather and couldn't make it up tonight.
That's January for you.
I'll tell you what, they're still hitting on all cylinders even without her. With that added attraction of Lucy Mendez, oh, my God, these guys are incredibly dangerous.
Yeah, they are. I mean, it's not like they're not tough enough on their own, but to add that extra element. Talk a little bit about how, you know, these guys are really good and – maybe they're just not getting enough credit. Maybe that's why they feel the need to pull stunts like that and pull the antics that they feel or that they pull.
Well, I'll tell you what. The water you swim in the tag team division and Proving Ground is fairly deep. I mean, we've got a lot of fairly well-known teams like Zero Gravity, like an IOU that we'll be seeing later tonight. Our former champs, the Hooligans. Quite a few names that have been through here that are legitimate, serious tag teams. And I'll tell you what, the Perfect Addiction have stepped right up. They were Central States guys, usually Central Illinois, maybe a little bit out of that area, but mainly Central Illinois. And they have proven they're ready to hang with nationally known talent. As you can see right here, look at them, double team Mike Outlaw. Now, these tactics aren't always pretty and aren't always appealing, but I'll tell you what, they take you to the winner's circle a lot of times in this game. And what a move by Randy Ray.
He could have separated his shoulder right there. He got dumped. Oh, but he continues to fight on.
I don't know how Mike Outlaw managed to get up out of that. But oh, and look at that. Knocks Mr. Nice right off the ring apron.
You got the you talked about the tag team division in Proving Ground Pro with teams like Team IOU. Number 4 in the tag team top 50 for the Indy Power Rankings in 2014. You know, you got to... I guess, again, on you know, they've kind of got little man syndrome. They're doing everything they can to get noticed, and even if they have to do cheap things to do it.
Well, they are definitely getting the notice. They're getting the wins. They're getting a reputation is what they're getting, and it's a dangerous team to contend with. These two guys, they can pull off a big win against virtually anybody. They really, truly have the skill to do that.
It's kind of... it's a catch-22. You go into a match that you're supposed to win. If you lose, though, where do you go from there? I mean, you go in there with a team that's makeshift, and you go in there, and what if you lose? I mean, they have to have that in the
back
of their
minds. That is rolling
minds.
Dice here tonight. Yeah. Honestly, that would be a huge setback to let Outlaw and Mr. Nice
go
beat them.
Right to the back of the line of that tag team division, and that is not where they want to be, clearly.
But that'll show you an example of the cockiness of a perfect addiction to come out here and put themselves in that situation.
Well, do you feel like they've been disrespected or feel like they feel disrespected?
Oh,
you got the big showcase tag team match of the Indy Midwest tag teams between Team IOU and Zero Gravity, and where's Perfect Addiction? They had to come out here and demand a match.
Absolutely Shanghai the show, but it's worked for them. At least they're getting some time in the ring, and look at that, a huge hit on Mike Outlaw and the Perfect Addiction back in the driver's seat. And what an obnoxious, cocky, disgusting pin by Randy Ray.
Working a little much to the crowd right there. If he could have hooked a leg and paid more attention to his opponent than the front row audience there, he might have come out on top.
Drapes Outlaw's throat across that second rope, though. Mike Outlaw is in some serious trouble here. Jason Pemberton is trying to lay the count on him, but double team tactics are not working out well for Mike Outlaw right now.
Yeah, I mean, there's no call.
Oh, and a
teabag.
That's disgusting.
That's the exact same thing that cost Mario his match earlier. Is this really the route that these guys want to go? But this is what they are.
They are the Perfect Addiction, and they are two of the cockiest guys in the Proving Ground. There's no doubt about it.
I think his hips are broken. They just keep
And what a nice elbow to the back of the head off the top rope from Randy
Imagine
Ray.
Imagine getting hit with an elbow when you don't know it's coming, because he was trying to get to his partner. Mike Outlaw is in desperate straits right now. He wants
Mike
to get
Outlaw
out of there in the worst
double
way.
Tough to get that shoulder off right there. I'm going to tell you that right now. Wow. But look at this. He is in a world of trouble. Oh, and a nice neck breaker from Barry Winkle.
And that's what I was talking about, being a quote-unquote real tag team, like Perfect Addiction here. You know, you've got moves like that in your repertoire. These two are just thrown together. They don't have these moves that are just in their arsenal right now. They're going to have to work as they go.
They will not have an assortment of double team moves to use to their advantage.
Again, it's two single guys against the tag team. It's bad odds. It is. But Mike Outlaw continuing to fight. And right now, he needs to make a tag.
And found himself a nice resourceful move off that second rope to sink in a big forearm, create a little separation, a little time, force Perry Winkle to make the tag. And look, Mike Outlaw
clothesline. Another
Mr. Nice.
Back elbow. Another back elbow. Mr. Nice.
Duck
nice.
Under
nice.
Mr. Nick Nice
breaker.
Is cleaning up
he
the
is
house.
He on fire. Oh, over the back breaker. Seen that one before. Coming in. Misses a clothesline. Springboard knee to the face.
Knee.
That
Nelson
may do it.
Nice is just absolutely on fire here.
You know, you've seen it so many times before where the fresh guy in the apron gets it, and I don't know
I don't
know
if that was a good idea.
Outlaw is not fresh right now, but they're going to try some tag team offense.
They're
going to
attempt a double team move here. This is too impromptu, I think. Oh, look, great
save. Saves his partner. Again, tag team.
Oh, and used him as a weapon.
Double boot. More tag team shenanigans. Oh!
Randy Ray using Barry Winkle as a weapon, Travis.
He hurt himself there. Couldn't make the cover. I don't know if he's the legal man anyway.
I have lost track. I hope
I
our
referee
Pemberton has an idea.
You couldn't pay me enough. A miss of a clothesline. Miss of another backhand.
Oh,
big
but he did not miss that big boot.
Outlaw, he just went down like a stack of potatoes right there. He is in big trouble.
Uh-oh.
Neck breaker.
A double team move and a neck breaker and Randy Ray rolling in. And we, two and a half.
I tell you what, there have been so many close calls in all these matches tonight. You can tell everybody is up their game for this night. For this night, for the chance to shine. Another solid punch.
And look at Nelson. Nice go, Mr. Nice. Absolutely laying in the soup bones, but two men is always going to beat one.
I think he made a tactical error when he tagged out earlier. And
or a mathematical error.
Yeah, absolutely. And now Outlaw's in the corner trying to recover, and he's taking a beating.
Oh, but a nice shoulder.
Oh, bigger man. Couldn't
find two of them, and a big enziguri sends him right into the arms of Randy Ray.
Oh, big spine buster.
Laid out on the floor in a splash by Winkle. Mr. Nice is in trouble. Look at this.
Outlaw, I believe he's the legal man still, though. And a gut-wrench suplex. Turns around, up on his shoulders. Oh.
Randy down on his Ray face. With a nice move. And once he set up for a big Larry to the
Northern
back of the
Lariat.
Head, that may be all it takes.
You know, a lot of Canadians here tonight. Northern Lariat's thrown in just for them.
Wait a minute. Randy Ray is set. Oh, and a big boot to the gut.
And an ace crusher. A stunner,
Ray is not completely to the floor. Periwinkle may be in trouble here.
Well, you know, he's missing his partner at the moment, though. Surprisingly, it's 2-on-1 and not the way I expected.
Periwinkle, though, holds on to the ropes and ducks that shoulder.
Trying to even the odds.
Scoops his eyes up and over, and oh, he blocks it into the corner. And look at Mr. Nice. Nelson Nice ramming Periwinkle's head into those turnbuckles. Is he going to suplex into that floor? Oh, my God, Travis.
If he takes him to the floor right now, he's going to break an ankle. He's
going
to break his foot. He's going to break something.
What a save yourself move by Periwinkle.
Same thing Mario used earlier. And a low blow, just like Mario. Again, you said they run in the same circle. It's obvious. And they win with
a
low
blow. Takes him home, and the music of the Perfect Addiction plays.
Addiction!
And, you know, these guys come out, they make an open challenge, and they win with a low blow. I mean, how does that impress anybody? That's what they wanted to do, but did they really? I don't know. I mean, I think
well,
that's
later, when they're Facebooking and tweeting, trust me,
oh, yeah.
All they're going to talk about is the win.
There's no doubt about it. A win's a win.
Did you hear about our big win? That's all they're going to say.
Yeah.
And they're going to hope you don't watch the tape.
They'll look for the record books and... To be honest with you, that's what the Indy Power Rankings are about. And these guys, they'll probably push themselves into the tag team poll this week because of this win.
Well, there's no reason they shouldn't start to get a little recognition there. These guys are very capable, very treacherous, but yes, very capable with anybody you want to put in the ring with them.
Solid match there, but you know the team that with the teams more frequently gets the victory, and again it was because of their tactics.